I hate V-Perm so much.
If V-Perm was a YouTube channel, I'd probably subscribe to him just so I could unsubscribe and see his subscriber count go down. Yeah, that's right, bitch. So I hate V-Perms. Maybe you hate V-Perms too. In this video, let's try and fix that. So I'm going to be talking about two things. Number one is to make sure you're doing your V-perms properly. That is to make sure you're doing all the finger tricks correctly. And the second thing that I'm going to talk about is alternative algorithms you could use. So in case this is your first time learning the V-perm, let me show you what the algorithm looks like. So it looks like this, then a rotation, so back from the beginning, we're going to do this and then do the first F prime move with our thumb, R2, U prime. Now here is the most important part of the V perm, where it's R prime U, R prime F, R F. So if I'm going to do that fast, using only my right index finger for all three of those moves, here's what it would look like. So it can be pretty fast, but it could also be a lot better. So here, when you get to the first U move here, then when you do this with your index finger, you don't want to use your index finger again for the F because you'll have to reset. So instead you can do U here with your index finger, then U here, I mean F here with your middle finger. Then afterwards you can reset and do F with your index finger. So again, that would look like this. And it doesn't make a big difference when I'm going that slow, but let's see a little bit faster. Now, another thing you can add to your V-perm is a thumb move like this at the end, so that you don't have to kind of reset your hand from this position into this to do the F at the end. So that would look something like this. Now, I'm not very good at this fast because I'm not good at thumb moves like this, but it's just something you can try out. It can make it really smooth. All right, lastly, one more important thing is that if you have a UAUF at the end, which means your block is misoriented and it needs to be solved using U after the V-perm is finished, then you have to make sure you do this quickly in a way that doesn't require a regrip. Now, this applies to all your PLLs in general, but for this V-perm, just make sure that you do it this way. So regular V-perm, and then do it like this. So V-perm with the UAUF a bit faster. Now, I do recommend that you use the standard algorithm for V-perm. I do think it's the best one, but here are some alternative ones in the order that I think they are good. So this one goes like this. And now a bit faster. If you just look at the algorithm, it does look like this should be the standard V-perm algorithm. And I thought that too when I first started practicing it, but then when I got good at this algorithm, then I realized some of the problems with it. So I'm just gonna start with why it's not better than the standard V-perm algorithm. So the first four moves are the same, then the speed of rotating once is kind of like the same speed as the next four moves. Then you have to regrip and then do this. And honestly, that part after the regrip is probably the same speed as the second part of this V-perm. So the last algorithm is an algorithm that people commonly use for one hand to do V-perms, and that goes like this. So first of all, before even thinking of trying this algorithm, you have to be able to do that D2 at the end. And this algorithm, I tend to make mistakes because of grip issues, like my hand's all over the place when doing this, so just watch. Yeah, my hand moves way too much, it's all over the place, there's never like a steady grip on the cube like when you do like a T-perm or a J-perm. But the main problem is right here, so go through a bit. So here we have R U prime, and notice how I barely grip the cube at all. Then I kind of have to regrip to do RU, and then everything after that is kind of okay. Now this next algorithm I think is the fastest V-perm algorithm there is. However, you need to rotate the cube first like this. Now here's what it looks like. Now here it is again a bit faster. Now if I actually practice this one, I think I could do it faster. Okay, there was a good one. So the way that I do it is a little bit different. I learned it from a YouTube video a long time ago, so I don't know which video it was. So the only difference in the way that I execute this is the third move. So D prime and then R2. Now instead of D with your left hand, notice that your index finger is in the correct spot to do that. And for some reason, I find that easier. Then the rest of the algorithm is the same. So not counting the cube rotation at the beginning, I think it is the fastest V-perm, but with the cube rotation, I don't think it's the fastest anymore. All right, so those are all of the alternative V-perm algorithms that I think are worth trying out. Now, if you think I missed any, you can leave it in the comments, and then if I like it, I'll add it to the description. All right, see you guys all next time, and I wish you no V-perms and many J-perms.